While Cricut has a large selection of fonts, and websites like daffont.com make it super easy to download an abundance of fonts for free, it's very likely that you're struggling to find that same variety when it comes to Hebrew fonts. In this video, I'll show you several different options, as well as tips on how to use Hebrew fonts effectively in design space. Hey there, I'm Goldie, and I post weekly videos on how to maximize your Cricut machine and create all sorts of things you never knew were possible. So the first resource we're going to look at is a website called hebrewfonts.net. All the sites I cover will be linked in the description below, so you can see it over here as I scroll down. Many different fonts, and if we click view all fonts, then you can see there's over 50 pages of them. You might be wondering, why are some of them squares, some of them English? Where's the Hebrew? To view the Hebrew letters, very often the text needs to be typed in Hebrew. We'll get into the Hebrew keyboard later on in the video, so stick around for that. But for now, let me just jump into one of these fonts and show you what I mean. So over here, underneath this line of boxes, you have a box to enter text to preview. I'm going to click in there and then change my keyboard to Hebrew, and then it will show you the Hebrew letters. So yeah, it might be a bit more time consuming to find the font that you want. You have to go into each one to see what it looks like. But once you've found a small selection that you like a basic font, a decorative one, a handwritten one, then there's really no need to go looking for more unless you need something really specific. Once you've found the font you like, all you need to do is hit the download button and you'll see it download right down here. Okay, let's go through a couple more resources and then we'll get into installing the font and using it in Design Space. This website is called hebrewfont.net. Almost the same as the previous one, just without the S at the end. And once again, you can see a variety of fonts. Usually you can see them here without having to input preview text. So that's a good thing. If you hit the plus icon on any of these sections or go to that section over here in this tab at the top, then you'll see a lot more fonts in that style. To download these, you just press download and then enter the captcha over here and press submit, and then it will download right down here. The third website we have is called Aleph. They primarily do paid fonts, but they do have a page with some free fonts available, and they say to come back every now and then to check because they sometimes add new ones. So there's a few here, and to download these, you just press download, and once again, it's right down here. So now we've found ourselves some pretty fonts. Let's get into installing them on the computer and using them in Cricut Design Space. So let's click on the file down here, or you can find it in your downloads folder, and open any folders that you encounter within it until you come across the file that has this icon, a white rectangle with an A on it. You should see its file type is an open type font file or a true type font file. Now you want to double click on that and hit install up here. And that's it. If you now open up a Word document and look for that font, you will find it in the list. However, if you had Design Space open while you were installing the font, like I did, you won't find it as one of your options. What you're going to have to do is close Design Space and reopen it in order for your new font to show up. So we now open a new project and add some text. We should be able to find the font. The place to look for your fonts is under this System tab. The Cricut tab contains all the Cricut fonts that belong to Cricut that can be found within Design Space. The system has all the fonts installed on your computer. And once you find your font, which was this one, you can press this little icon here to bookmark it so that it shows up in the bookmark tab. This is good for fonts that you know you're going to use often, that you want to come back to every time. You don't have to search for them. You can just come right here and find the fonts you like. Okay, we're almost ready to use our new font, but how do we get to the Hebrew keyboard? To do that, you're going to need to go into your device's keyboard settings. All the instructions I'm going to be giving here are for Windows PC. I imagine that the directions won't be too different for a Mac. You'll go with where your settings are, you look for the language settings or the keyboard settings, whatever they might be under, and you should have there some option to add a keyboard. So let's go down here and search for language, and you should have an option come up called Edit Language and Keyboard Options. Here you'll see what languages you have. If you've never edited the languages on your device, you'll probably just have English. What we're going to do is add a language and then look for Hebrew and press next. We can just leave it as is and press install. Then we're just going to wait for it to finish installing. And there we have it. Now that it's installed, you can quickly toggle between languages as you type using the keyboard shortcut left alt and shift. If you look down here where your language shows up, we press left alt shift and it's now English, left alt shift and it's Now, Hebrew. By left alt, we mean the left alt key. You should have an alt key on either side of your spacebar. It's the one on the left at the same time as the shift key, and you can switch languages. Another alternative is to press the Windows key and spacebar. If you're not familiar with the layout of the Hebrew keyboard, you can put up the on-screen keyboard using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+O, and then on it, you can toggle the language on it again with left alt and shift, or Windows and spacebar. Alternatively, you can buy a keyboard sticker set to stick onto your keys so that you can see them as you type, and I'll link one of those below. Finally, now that we're all set, let's head back into design space. We have our text box, we switch our keyboard to Hebrew, and we type. Now, obviously, now it's in boxes because we're not on Hebrew font, but we know we have a bookmarked font right here. And here you can see the problem. It comes up backwards. Cricut types Hebrew like it does English, from left to right. Now, for small words, I find it easiest to simply type backwards, and you do get better at this with a bit of practice. So, there we go. It can take a little getting used to think of the word backwards and which order to type it. One tip I use is to write it down on a piece of paper and then follow it backwards to see which letters go where. But for longer text, I use an online tool called ConvertCase.net. All you have to do is go to the reverse text generator tab, type in or paste whatever you want to say, and then copy to clipboard from the output box. Then we go back into Cricut and paste it, and you have it exactly how you need it. From here, everything is pretty much the same as usual. You can increase the font size, you can change the colors. Well, there you have it. The best places to get Hebrew fonts, how to install them and get them running on your computer, and how to fix Cricut's left to right default typing. Please let me know in the comments if this video helped you, and feel free to leave suggestions for which videos you'd like to see next. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.